TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 30th of May. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi takes oath for second term. Two terrorists neutralize an encounter in India's Jammu and Kashmir. And at least six killed in blast near Afghan military training center. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi took oath for a second term along with a new Union Council of Ministers on Thursday after a massive victory in the general election last week. From just two seats in the parliament in 1984 to winning two back-to-back majority in the general election, Modi's Bharatiya Janata Party has firmly taken the center stage of India's political landscape. A ceremony involving military bands, Hindu holy men and world leaders was laid on at the Indian Presidential Palace in New Delhi on Thursday for Prime Minister Narendra Modi swearing in for a second term. The swearing-in ceremony at the forecourt of the colonial-era presidential palace was attended by thousands of guests, including Bollywood stars, top industrialists and leaders of BIMSTEC member nations. Modi and his new Union Council of Ministers was administered oath by Indian President Ramnath Kovind after a massive victory in the general election last week.
I, Narendra Damodar Das Modi, ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि मैं विधि द्वारा स्थापित भारत के संविधान के प्रति सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगा। मैं भारत की प्रभुता और अखंडता अक्षुण्ण रखूंगा।
Modi won a massive mandate in the general election that ended this month after focusing his campaign on national security as tension with old rival Pakistan shot up over a deadly terror attack on security forces in India's Jammu and Kashmir in February. Modi's Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP now controls 303 of the 545 seats in the lower house of parliament. It was the first back-to-back majority in the lower house of parliament for a single party since 1984. Two terrorists were neutralized by security forces in an encounter in Sopore town of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province on Thursday. The encounter broke out after a search operation was launched early in the morning upon specific inputs about the presence of the terrorists. This came 2 days after security forces gunned down two terrorists in a similar encounter in Anantnag district of the province on Tuesday. India has long accused neighboring Pakistan of arming and infiltrating terrorists from across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan, however, denies the allegations. In news from Pakistan, scores of members of Pakistan People's Party clashed with police in Islamabad as the leader Bilawal Bhutto Zardari appeared before the National Accountability Bureau in connection with the fake accounts case on Wednesday. Bilawal, after returning from the court, condemned the police action against his party workers and termed it as state brutality.
Pakistan's People's Party chairperson Bilawal Bhutto Zardari condemned the police action against his party workers on Wednesday and termed it as state brutality. Members of the Pakistan People's Party or PPP clashed with police in Islamabad on Wednesday as Bilawal Bhutto Zardari appeared before the National Accountability Bureau in connection with the fake accounts case. Scores of PPP members and parliamentarians carrying party flags and chanting slogans scuffled with police, after which the police resorted to using water cannons to stop them. Addressing media after returning from court, Bilawal said he was collecting video evidence of the clashes and was ready to go to the court to seek retribution.
कानून में कहीं नहीं लिखा है कि आपके साथी आपको कंपनी नहीं कर सकते हैं, आपका साथी पुरमन तरीके से आपके साथ जा सकते हैं, लेकिन इसके बावजूद पाकिस्तान पीपल्स पार्टी के कारकुन, पाकिस्तान पीपल्स पार्टी के इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स बोथ हाउसेस वर टुडे अटैक्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ मिस्टर इमरान खान. Force was used against peaceful citizens. I don't even say peaceful protesters because they weren't protesting.
Bilawal Bhutto Zardari was on Wednesday given a questionnaire and asked to submit his response within 10 days in connection with the fake accounts case, a local media report said.
In news from Afghanistan, a suicide bomber blew himself up at the entrance of a military training center in the Afghan capital Kabul on Thursday, killing at least 6 people. The explosion occurred as cadets were leaving the college, which is one of Afghanistan's main officer training academies.
A suicide bomber blew himself up at the entrance of a military training center in Afghan capital Kabul on Thursday, killing at least 6 people and wounding 6 others, police said. A security official said the attacker detonated his explosives after being prevented from entering the Marshal Fahim National Defense University to the west of Kabul. The explosion occurred as cadets were leaving the college, which is one of Afghanistan's main officer training academies. There was no immediate claim of responsibility for the attack, which came as Taliban representatives met senior Afghan politicians in Russia as part of efforts to reach a settlement to end the 18-year-long conflict.
More news from Afghanistan. Taliban on Wednesday rejected calls for ceasefire in Afghanistan during Moscow talks, saying it's not possible in presence of foreign forces in the country. Ceasefire was one of the main demands by Afghan politicians who publicly raised it at a ceremony in Moscow on Tuesday.
A group of Afghan politicians led by former President Hamid Karzai and a 14-member Taliban team led by the co-founder of the group, Abdul Ghani Baradar, sat for the second day in Moscow to discuss Afghan peace, but behind closed doors on Wednesday. Media reports said the second day of the meeting was focused on peace and pressuring the Taliban to agree on a ceasefire with the Taliban at least during the upcoming Muslim festival of Eid al-Fitr. But backing their deputy leader's stance, a Taliban spokesperson on Wednesday said that ceasefire is not possible in presence of foreign forces in Afghanistan.
هنگامی که کشور اشغال شده باشد، یک اتش بف چگونه ممکن بوده میتواند؟
Taliban officials have been talking to US diplomats for months about the terms of a withdrawal of more than 23,000 US and NATO coalition troops from Afghanistan. Both the sides have reached a draft agreement on some issues, but no new date for the next round of talks has been set and many obstacles remain.
It is from Nepal. Sahara Hillary, daughter of Sir Edmund Hillary, the first man to climb the world's tallest peak on Wednesday, said that obsession of Mount Everest is killing climbers. Hillary, who was in Nepal for an event, said people should look beyond Mount Everest and climb other peaks too.
Sarah Hillary, daughter of the first man to scale the world's highest peak, Sir Edmund Hillary, on Wednesday said that it was a shame most climbers were obsessed with Mount Everest and not taking up the challenge of climbing other peaks. Sarah Hillary, who was in Kathmandu to receive an award of appreciation from the Nepali authorities for her contribution to the mountaineering community on the 66th anniversary of her father's summit, said that too many people on Mount Everest were part of the reason for the deaths. 11 people have already died in this year's climb on both Nepal and Tibetan sides, mostly due to exhaustion.
Well, I mean, clearly there's too many people on the mountain, but I think the greatest shame is that more climbers don't climb other mountains. There's so many amazing peaks in Nepal, and they're all very challenging. I think it would be wonderful if people looked to other mountains and weren't so obsessed with Everest.
I think that this is not any such a abnormal case, because Mount Everest itself is adventure, you know. So people are here to enjoy adventure, and they know that this type of accident may happen. But one thing is, we are serious about the safety and security of the mountaineers and other tourists in Nepal.
Over 381 climbers were permitted to scale the summit from the Nepali side this season, while 130 others were tackling Everest from the mountain's northern side in Tibet. The route, also called the South Col Route, was pioneered by New Zealander Sir Edmund Hillary and Nepalese Sherpa Tenzing Norgay in 1953. About 5,000 people have scaled the Everest summit so far, and about 300 have died on its slopes.
Scores of Buddhist monks and nuns on Wednesday gathered in India's northern Himalayan desert town of Leh to take part in an annual prayer retreat. They marched on the roads of the hill town carrying an idol of Lord Gautam Buddha while chanting religious hymns in a peace procession. Scores of Buddhist monks and nuns on Wednesday gathered on the streets of Himalayan desert town of Leh in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir to take part in an annual prayer retreat called Mullam. The devotees, mostly exiled Tibetans, marched on the roads of the hill town carrying an idol of Lord Gautam Buddha while chanting religious hymns in a peaceful procession. This was the 27th Mullam meet of the exiled Tibetans, which is an annual prayer meet of the Tibetan monks and nuns from four sects and monasteries of the Ladakh region.
यहाँ वार्षिक पूजा हो रहा है मल्लम तो मल्लम में हमारे पूरे चारों संप्रदायों का लामा इकट्ठे होके और रिम्पोचे इकट्ठे होके पाँच दिन पूजा हर साल होते हैं तो तीसरे दिन हमने मैत्रेय बुद्धा का दर्शन करने के लिए हमने पूरा बाजार में हम सब शांति मार्च किए हैं.
In this retreat, all the monasteries of Ladakh, all the monks and nuns of Ladakh are assembled, and we do this retreat every year. It's an annual occasion, and it is the 27th such retreat.
Hundreds of devotees participate in the prayers every year, marching to pray for peace and well-being of the entire humanity. According to the tradition, these prayers are performed for the longevity of the spiritual teachers of monks and to pray for an obstacle-free pursuance of their spiritual goals. Devout Hindus on Wednesday walked on burning embers in India's southern Shivamoga town to show their devotion for their local deity. They also took out a procession while dancing and playing drums before walking on fire.
Devout Hindus on Wednesday walked on burning embers in Shivamoga town of India's southern Karnataka province to show their devotion for Hindu deity goddess Antaraghatamma. The devotees gathered at the temple and took out a procession with the idols while dancing and playing drums before walking on fire. Men and women alike took up to the peculiar task of faith in pleasing the goddess to pray for prosperity and good fortune.
ನಮ್ಮ ಕಷ್ಟಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಪಾರು ಮಾಡುವ ನಿನ್ನ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಬೆಳೆದಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಒಳ್ಳೇದು ಮಾಡು ತಾಯಿ ಅನ್ನು ತೊಂದೆ
300-400 ವರ್ಷದ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಇರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಇದು ಗ್ರಾಮ ಇದು ಅಂದರೆ ಸುಮಾರು ಒಂದು ಕೆಲವೊಂದು 10-15 ಮನೆ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದಂಥ ಹೊಸಮನೆ ಗ್ರಾಮ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಈ ಗ್ರಾಮ ದೇವತೆ ಅಂತರ್ಘಟ್ಟಮ್ಮ ದೇವರು ಇದು ಮೊದಲು ಪೂರ್ವ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಗುಡಿಸ್ಲಲ್ಲಿತ್ತು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕರಿ ಹಂಚಿಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿತ್ತು ಅದ್ರ ನಂತರ 70ರ ದಶಕದಲ್ಲಿ ತಾರಸಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ಆಯಿತು ಈಗ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಆಧುನಿಕವಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಸೇರಿ ಈ ಗ್ರಾಮದವರು ಮತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ ಯುವಕರು ಸೇರಿ ಈ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನನ ಆಧುನೀಕರಣಗೊಳಿಸಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು.
Fire walking is an ancient ritual originated in India and is often practiced to show people's devotion and faith to their deities in different parts of the country.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.